head teacher of the KG section, Ms. Claudine Cotino, and head teacher of the primary section, Ms. Lucinda Di Costa.
We request you to rise as we welcome them.
As each annual day dawns, it gives me a great feeling, a feeling of wonder and awe to see what a lot of practice goes on in organizing to put various programs
during the course of the year, and a reminder to others to wake up and sit back, applaud and appreciate their worth performance. It is a tradition of Holy Name High School to appreciate the efforts put in by students in every branch of knowledge. The annual prize distribution is preceded by a cultural program. Parents are able to see for themselves that good education is one that provides for an all-round development in a child. It is an eye-opener to a parent as they realize that there are more fields that want to display talents. So, let's mingle ourselves in the enchanting music of Sur, Lai or Taal. We begin our program with a welcome song put by our very own secondary students.
Engineering College with a degree in Mechanical Engineering and and served as Commissioner of Brihan Mumbai Municipal Corporation from 29th February 2004 to May 2007. Mr. Joseph was a Maharashtra's Principal Secretary to the Chief Minister before the state government granted him the post of the Civic Chief of Mumbai. He was succeeded by Jairaj Pathak in May 2007. On 1st May 2007, he was appointed as Chief Secretary of Maharashtra in 2007. His wife, Mrs. Reena Joseph, is an active environmentalist and patron of several social causes. He enjoys a good rapport with the ruling UPA and is in the good books of the Congress at the center. He successfully handled his job as the BMS Commissioner and the Chief Secretary. Mr. Joseph is known as a balanced Commissioner Administrator, said a source. He is at present a member of Maharashtra's UPA Lokayukta. He told Mumbai Mirror, "I feel that it is a desirable to establish a separate investigative agency under the Lokayukta on the lines of the Karnataka pattern for effective implementation of the objectives of the Lokayukta legislation. He is an inspiration to the future generation."
We will now have the lighting of the lamp. May I request our chief guest, guest of honor, our principal, Father Nicholas Pereira, our manager, Father Cesar De Mello, Father Gregory Lobo, and our vice principal, Ms. Susan Jong, to come up and light the lamp. As the heart is purified and made constant, as the mind and the feelings are directed in God, you begin to feel His joy.
Yeah.
Our council members will present bouquet of flowers to Father Caesar, Father Gregory, and Monsignor Willie Nazareth.
Fuck!
second home of the child. It is very important to know the academic of achievements of the of a child, including the school. So we have our vice principal, Ms. Susan John, who will read out to us a school report.
And all. On behalf of the principal, Reverend Father Nicholas Pereira, the staff and students of the Holy Name High School, it gives me great honor to present to you the school annual report. The Holy Name High School caters to all-round development of the child. So all our activities and programs are primarily and centrally geared towards the harmonious growth of the child entrusted to our care. On June 16th, we welcomed Reverend Father Nicholas Pereira as the new principal of our school. Father Nicholas was the principal of St. John the Baptist High School and Junior College, Thane, and after serving there for 6 years, has been handed over the reins of our school. We are enjoying working with him, and it is indeed a privilege to have him as our principal. The SSC results announced in the month of June speak of our academic progress. For the third year in a row, we secured 100% results at the SSC exams, with 51 distinctions, 102 students passing with a first class, and 34 students with a second class. Ms. Vidya Pawar topped the records with a percentage of 93.64. Congratulations to all our students, and we wish them greater success in their future. On 29 June, we had the investiture ceremony, where a new team of school council members took an oath for diligent performance and service to the school. We have the open day regularly, creating opportunities for parents to interact with our teachers and inform them of their child's progress. Student teachers from the Bombay Teachers Training College started their D.Ed. and B.Ed. practice lessons in July with the goal of becoming ideal teachers. The Parents Teachers Association meeting was held on 6th August. Functions are an integral part of school life. National festivals like Independence Day and Republic Day are celebrated with cultural programs, speeches, and songs. On 15th August, Ms. Vidya Pawar, our SSC topper, was the guest of honor along with her parents, and Ms. Lucinda DeCosta, the head teacher of the primary section, was the chief guest. 5th September, a day to honor our beloved teachers and show our respect and appreciation for them, began with a meaningful liturgy and a prayer service, followed by a cultural program organized by our students, culminating in a lunch party in the school hall. The PTA members too provided tremendous help and support in the celebration of this day. To develop in our students a love for our national language Hindi, a Hindi Week celebration was held from 12th September to 17th September. During the week, handwriting and essay writing competitions were organized for students of the secondary section. The highlight of the Hindi Week celebration was the inter-house debate competition between the 5th and 6th, 7th and 8th, and the 9th and 10th standards. It's not all work and no play at Holy Name. Our tiny tots from the KG went to the Hanging Garden, primary section students to SL World, and the students of the secondary section went to the Water Kingdom for their class excursions. They surely had a rollicking time. The first semester exam was held in the month of October, followed by the Diwali vacation. Children's Day was celebrated with much fervor on the 19th of November, and an entertainment program was put up for our dear students, where the juggler amazed the students and the magician enthralled them. Our teachers sang and also gave an energetic dance performance. Our school hosted the 30th AB Board Science Exhibition from 29th November to 1st December. At the exhibition, Mr. John Fernandez, our lab assistant, won the third prize for his project Magic of Pencil. The project Smart Life for Smart Mumbaikers won the third prize. The teacher in charge was Ms. Rajni Solanki, along with the students Hussein Chatrisa and Harshank Raghuveer. The teaching aid mathematical stadium made by Mr. Jerome De Silva won the second prize. Ms. Scarlett Fernandez won the second prize as the elocution competition. And our school band won the third prize at the band competition. The various educational clubs in our school have been arranging different activities for the students. The English club conducted the English elocution competition in the month of July and the choral recitation in August. Nature club. The nature club members sowed methi seeds in the school background, and on 20th August, which is observed as Energy Conservation Day, a poster competition was held for students from the 5th to the 9th standards. Interact Club. The members of the club conducted newspaper drives in June and July, and they visited the Piety Old Age Home at Cherney Road in August. Art and Culture Club. They organized a card competition on 23rd July on the occasion of Parents' Day and have been actively helping in the decoration and preparation of backdrops for all school functions. Sports Club. They held the Inter-House Carom competition in July, table tennis competition in August, and the football competition in September. The club also arranged for a hiking and trekking trip for students of the secondary section to Bushi Dam in Lonavala. Cyber Club. They organized a PowerPoint competition for students of the 8th standard. The members have actively assisted our teachers to download information from the internet, and they also update the digital display board with the thought for the day and other events. Upcoming events. In keeping with the Christmas mood, our students will participate in the carol singing competition, and the primary section also has a fancy dress competition. Both the sections will put up tableaux to spread the message of love and peace. Also coming up is the annual athletic meet, the Republic Day celebration, the SSC farewell, the school feast, and the staff picnic. God has been good to us, and we thank Him for our ex-principal, Reverend Father Michael Pinto, who lavished his interest on the welfare of our students, working tirelessly to take holy name to greater heights. We wish him good health, success, and greater achievement as the principal of St. John the Baptist High School and Junior College. I wish to thank our principal, manager, our teachers, the office staff, the subordinate staff, and our parents for their constant support and guidance. There can be no basking in the sunshine of past glory, no resting on the laurels earned with courage and fervor. We will move forward with God's help to achieve daily the ideals we have set before us. Thank you.
Education is the soul of society. As it passes from one generation to the next, it is very important to educate and children and not just fill their minds. The minds of the children have to be ignited. Every activity teaches them something. It does not really matter the breath you take in, but it is breathless experience you create that makes the difference.
We now move on to the most important event of this evening, without which none of us will be present here in this quadrantum. Now is the time to award all those who have shown their excellence in the field of education, and for which I call upon our dear teacher, Ms. Florine, to take over.
Mr. Johnny Joseph, Mrs. Rina Joseph, Father Gregory Lobo, and Father Cesar DeMello. Please put your hands together for them.
Junior KG 1, Junior KG A. The first prize goes to Vadulu Bavika. The second prize goes to Thakur Tanisha. The third prize goes to Vatkar Harshad. Go to Junior KGB. The first prize goes to Ja Arjun. Second prize goes to Patil Ashish. The third prize goes to Danur Palak. Junior KGC, the first prize goes to Undare Vidya. The second prize goes to Hate Pratik. The third prize goes to Mashilkar Kasturi. We go to Junior KGD. The first prize goes to Sindhya Swani. The second prize goes to Hate Aditya. The third prize goes to Bopi Lavanya. Now we go to Senior KGA. Second prize goes to Ayer Arman. The third prize goes to Guptas Shimran. Senior KGB, first prize goes to Nangaonkar Vedika. Second prize goes to Kawad Harshad. The third prize goes to Titus Swidil. Senior KG C, first prize goes to Simarwala Zaid. Second prize goes to Sarang Saeed. The third prize goes to Nakawa Soha. Senior KGD, first prize goes to Rathod Divya. Second prize goes to Arekar Shriya. And the third prize goes to Dakini Purva. I now hand over the mic to Ms. Sarojini.
Number two, Ms. Daraksha Sheikh. Three, Piyush Baswat. Four, Rahib Sayyad. From the first B, we have Vishaka Malode. Ayaz Sartan. Asfiya Khan. Antal Maurya. First C, Fiza Akhtar. Nathan Bandari. Jitendra Pandit. First D, Alok Kamle. Joel Fernandez. Ryan D'Souza. Second day, Kedar Ranthambe. Jatin Tare. Veda Pawar. Divya Khamle. Zainab Sheikh. Krish Chauhan. Munira Baranwala. Aisha Sheikh. Krish Chaurasia. Siddharth Shah. Elvin Rodriguez. I now hand over the mic to Ms. Flory.
Thank you, Ms. Sir. Nabia Merchant. Smita Rajwadia. We call upon Ryan to receive his prize. Please clap, parents. Thank you. Third B, Mohsin Sheikh. Rohit Khadka. Chuveria Sheikh. Third C, Faizan Tai.
Abdullah Ansari. Sonali Kamle. Third D. Adil Fanicharwala. Habiba Qureshi. Shraddha Kadam. Fourth standard. Fourth A. Sakshi Palkar. Hatim Bootwala. Abhishek Gupta. Fourth B, Rishabh Patil. Parents, please clap louder. It's a great achievement for the kids. Sakina Kapasi. Taha Sadanpurwala. Fourth B, Prachi Pawar. Fourth C, sorry. Mutha Surti. Clarissa Naruna. Fourth D, Jaden D'Souza. Mateen Mansuri. Adnan Lakdawala. I now hand over the mic to Ms. Rohini. Thank you, Father Gregory.
We move on with the prize distribution for the secondary section. Prizes will be given to the first three toppers of each standard. I now request our manager, Reverend Father Cesar DeMello, to do the honor. In standard 5, we have Mehek Memon. They are the first three toppers of each standard only, so the clapping mustn't stop. Thank you. Mariam Khan. Standard 6, Joshua Gomes. Ali Asghar Sanwarwala. Standard 7, Manish Lanke. Nisha Gupta. Standard 8, Sonali Hate. Mahima Mahida. Hussein Chatrisa. Standard 9, Mamta Chauhan for general proficiency, and she also receives the Murli Deora Trophy for the best all-round student.
Raghuveer. Thank you, Father Caesar. She also tops in Marathi and Hindi, and she is awarded with the Holy Name Scholarship No. 7, the Shailaja Muller Scholarship, the late Mrs. L. M. Patole Scholarship, the Inas Kun Nirantar Scholarship, the Mother Teresa Scholarship, and the Rashida Kantawala Scholarship. A big hand for her, ladies and gentlemen. Joseph Anachawala tops in maths and is awarded the Holy Name Scholarship No. 6, the Avinash Patel Scholarship and the Suresh Golapalli Scholarship. Afsana Sultana tops in English and Maths and is awarded the Mrs. Mary Eviet Scholarship, the late Mrs. Pushpa Susainathan Scholarship, the Suresh Golapalli Scholarship. Adnan Tinwala tops in Science, Maths, EVS and PT and so is awarded the Vijay Jain Scholarship, the Sri Y.R. Coates Scholarship, the late Mr. Punchu Kuting Das Scholarship, the Suresh Golapalli Scholarship and the Mother Teresa Scholarship. Aniket Khaire tops in Social Studies and is awarded the late Mrs. Pushpa Susainathan Scholarship. Yajna Nakwa tops in Maths and Computers and receives the Suresh Golapalli Scholarship. Khairunisa Sayed is awarded the Bishop William Gomes Silver Jubilee Scholarship. Joseph Alam is awarded for his all-round performance and he receives the Holy Name Youth Club Scholarship and the Miss Pridula Patel Scholarship. He is absent today. Sean D'Souza is awarded the Anna Martin's Scholarship No. 1 and 2 and the late Mr. Joseph George Pires Scholarship. Just clapping now. Johnson Vegas tops in maths and is awarded the late Maria L.A. Pinto Scholarship No. 2, the Suresh Golapalli Scholarship and the Cardinal Simon Pimenta Scholarship. Michael Simeong is awarded for his all-round performance and he receives the Father F.X. Fernandez Scholarship, the D'Andrew D'Souza Scholarship and the scholarship sponsored by the batch of 1974 for the student who shows interest and enthusiasm in studies. Thank you, Michael. Kunal Thanu tops in maths. He's absent. Chetana Chivalkar gets the DISA and Family Scholarship No. 2. Ramroop Gupta gets the Mrs. Leela Marvin Kurve Scholarship No. 1. Sanjana Rao gets the DISA and Family Scholarship No. 2. Nitika Vaishnav gets the DISA and Family Scholarship No. 2. Pavit Pillai gets the J. Wilfred D'Souza Scholarship. Rizwan Patanwala tops in maths and gets the Suresh Golapalli Scholarship. Rahul Tambe also tops in maths and gets the Suresh Golapalli Scholarship. Another maths is Vishal Thorat, who also gets the Suresh Golapalli Scholarship. Bhavik Vaghela gets the Suresh Golapalli Scholarship for topping in maths. Danish Marwadi tops in maths and gets the Suresh Golapalli Scholarship. Rakhi tops in maths and is awarded the Suresh Golapalli Scholarship, the late T.V. Rangan Scholarship and the late Mrs. Sylvia Athait Scholarship. Charlene Kangaroo for Social Service gets the Mother Teresa Scholarship. Estrella Tellis is given the Carla Kevin Award. Anthony Fernandez gets the Dr. and Mrs. Fred Nazareth Scholarship. James Gaikwad gets the late Joseph Chagas Pereira Scholarship. Christina Maridas gets the late Joseph Chagas Pereira Scholarship. Mr. Suresh Hate receives the late Mrs. Laura Pereira Scholarship for the best pune of our school. Give him a bigger hand.
The backbone of the school is the management, but of course the most important part of the backbone is our teachers. There are a number of teachers who have been serving this institution for more than 25 years. Day to day and day out, they have been coming, traveling and forming our students. And two of our teachers have completed 25 years of service in this institution, to whom we like to felicitate today for their dedication, for their hard work, their commitment and the task that is given to them. They have been performing so well. Mr. Shabir Kantawala and Mrs. Regina Dias, these two teachers who have completed 25 years of their service in this institution. I call upon Mr. Sanjay sir to speak about Mr. Shabir Kantawala and then for Mrs. Regina Dias.
पूज्य शिक्षकगण, प्रिय विद्यार्थियों तथा समुपस्थित मित्रों, सर शबीर अहमद काटावाला, यह नाम होली नेम हाई स्कूल में किसी परिचय का मोहताज नहीं है। जी हाँ, आप पिछले 25 वर्षों से स्कूल में सफलतापूर्वक शिक्षा प्रदान कर रहे हैं। रजतमयी इस उपलब्धि के लिए मैं सर संजय, इस स्कूल के समस्त शिक्षक वर्ग की ओर से आपको आत्मिक अभिनंदन देता हूं और साथ ही स्वर्णमयी भावी सफलता के लिए ढेरों शुभकामनाएं। सर, आपने गणित और विज्ञान जैसे विषय का जितनी गहराई से अध्ययन किया, उतनी ही तन्मयता से आपने इन विषयों का अध्यापन भी कराया। आपने हमेशा कक्षा के प्रत्येक विद्यार्थी की शिक्षा को अनिवार्य माना है। आप विद्यार्थियों को विषय वस्तु का सहज और सरल ज्ञान देने के अलावा उनके आचरण और अनुशासन को भी महत्वपूर्ण मानते हैं। अपने अनवरत प्रयासों से आपने कई शिक्षार्थियों को कामयाब व्यक्ति बनाया है। इसके लिए किसी प्रमाण पत्र की जरूरत नहीं कि आपका जीवन शिक्षा और शिक्षार्थियों को समर्पित रहा है। सर, आपने अपनी कार्य कुशलता से ही नहीं बल्कि अपनी व्यवहार कुशलता से भी हम सभी का दिल जीत लिया है। इन तमाम वर्षों में आपने हम सभी को जो अपना अमूल्य सहयोग दिया है, उसके लिए हम सभी आपके तहे दिल से आभारी हैं। सर्वशक्तिमान परवरदिगार से हम बार बार यही दुआ करते हैं कि आप स्वस्थ व खुशहाल रहकर इसी तरह निष्ठापूर्वक अपना कर्तव्य निर्वाह करते रहे। वंस अगेन, बिफोर आई कंक्लूड माई स्पीच, कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशंस सभी फॉर योर सिल्वर जुबली इन दिस इंस्टीट्यूशन एंड थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर योर डेडिकेटेड सर्विस एंड ह्यूमनाइज कंसर्न। May God bless you.
To hand over the trophy to Shabir sir for his dedicated service to this institution for last 25 years.
Thank you.
Reverend Father Nicholas Pereira, Ajja Karyakramache Pramukh Pahune, Mr. Mrs. Johnny Joseph, Mukhyadhyaka Upa Mukhyadhyaka Mrs. Miss Susan, Paryavekshika Mrs. Leela, Shikshak Palak Ani Majha Vidyarthi Mitrano. आज आपले मिस रेजिना डायस यांनी या होली नेम शिक्षण संस्थेत आपल्या ज्ञानदानाच्या कार्याला 25 वर्ष पूर्ण केलेली आहेत. त्याबद्दल आम्ही सर्व त्यांचे अभिनंदन करतो. मिस रेजिना या मुळीच्या वसई येथल्या असून त्यांची कार्यशाळा कुलाबा येथे आहे. 9 जुलै 1986 पासून त्या होली नेम शाळेत कार्यरत आहेत. मिस रेजिना अत्यंत शांत स्वभावाची असून आपल्या विद्यार्थी वर्गात अतिशय प्रिय आहेत. स्वभावाने अतिशय प्रेमळ, मनमिळाऊ, कर्तव्यदक्ष अशा त्या शिक्षिका आहेत. त्या आपल्या कामात अत्यंत काटेकोर असून आपले काम वेळेवर पूर्ण करणे हे त्यांचा महत्त्वाचा गुण आहे. नेहमी हसतमुख, आनंदी, निर्गमी असे त्यांचे व्यक्तिमत्व असून आपल्या विद्यार्थ्यांना मदत करण्यात त्या नेहमीच अग्रेसर असतात. देवाने त्यांना ही 25 वर्षे होली नेम शिक्षण संस्थेमध्ये सेवा करण्याचे भाग्य दिले, त्याबद्दल आम्ही देवाचे आभार मानतो. त्याचप्रमाणे या शाळेतील त्यांच्या उर्वरित कार्याला चांगले आरोग्य व उदंड आयुष्य द्यावे हीच प्रभुचरणी प्रार्थना करतो. कॉन्ग्रॅच्युलेशन. थँक यू.
Today I regret to announce the death of one of our teacher, Mangala Chodankar, who served this institution for quite many years. But because of her sickness for the last 3 years, she was out of her service for the treatment. She expired yesterday. On behalf of the management, students and the staff, I ask you to stand for 2 minutes in silence and pray for the repose soul of Mrs. Mangala.
A very good evening. First of all, I thank you all on behalf of Ms. Regina. She would not like to come and speak. Anyhow, a very good evening to respected Reverend Father Nicholas Pereira, respected Father Caesar, our honorable chief guest, Mr. and Mrs. Joni Joseph, all the other fathers and sisters, all the invitees, all guests, teachers, and dear students. Today I have taken an opportunity to thank all my people whom I have faced for all these 25 years. Firstly, I would like to thank Father Joachim DeCosta, as he was the one who appointed me in this school. He appointed me and went away in June, and a new principal came. He was Luis Pereira. He was a very generous person. During his 3 years tenure, we teachers had an opportunity to have Teachers' Day celebrations in 5-star hotels also. One time we went to Taj Mahal and one time we went to President Hotel. I thank my second principal, Father Ivo D'Souza, who did a lot of work for underprivileged and was very concerned for poor people. May God bless him with good health. I also express my heartfelt thanks to my third principal, Father Paul, who was a very humble human being, but he stayed in the school for only 1 year. I am also grateful to my fourth principal, Father Clifton Lobo. I remember once I went to Father Clifton and requested him to make me the class teacher of standard 10th. He just smiled, and the very next June I was the class teacher of 10th standard. Thanks to Father Clifton. My fifth principal was Marvin D'Souza. In his time I faced some difficulties, but what he told me, Shabir, go to the staff room, relax, and don't increase your pressure. A big smile he gave me. Thank you, Father Marvin. My sixth principal was Father Michael Pinto. He went away very soon. Lot of work he did for our Holy Name High School. Coming to teachers, I thank Mrs. Benaifer first, who always supports me when I am tensed up. She tells me to keep cool and calm. When Mrs. Gulcher sometimes talks to me, I remember my sister who died some 12 years ago. I thank Miss Gloria, who is always cool. Other science colleagues, Mrs. Shalini, Janet and Rajni also, who all cooperate during setting of papers and syllabus. Thank you to all of them. I also thank Miss Mary, Regina, Cecilia, Darlene, Vina, Wilma, Julie and all the other young colleagues. In my staff room, Sanjay sir is like a family. Prashant and Phillips are like my brothers and friends. I also thank Arif, Melvin and Jackson. Thanks to Mr. Mishra, who offers me a rest chair when I return back to the staff room. Praful is always there when there is a need. Thanks him. I remember Mr. Suresh Hate, our peon, who was looking after our gents staff room before. A very kind person, always saying yes. Now, since last few years or last many years, Mr. Joseph looks after our staff room. He offers me the first lunch after I finish my Ramzan. Thanks, Mr. Joseph. Thank you very much. Also, thanks to my office staff, Ms. Priya, Sarina, Angelina, Benny and Dorothy, and other support staffs. Thanks to dear Vice Principal, Ms. Susan, Mrs. Stella. They take very much care of me while preparing timetable, giving substitutions. They prefer me last when they don't find anybody, and giving me the duties. Today I would like to thank the four great people who stood firmly behind me during my crisis which I faced in 1 year of my school life. Thanks Mr. Martins, who has left the school and is settled in Goa. I thank Miss Agnes Alvarez, who is also retired. I thank Miss Nilofa Merchant, who also stood behind me, I know. And thanks Miss Mercy Fernandez, who has also left the school. Thank you very much. I am here and celebrating 25 years because of these four people also. Thanks to the children. Many of my children have become like my teachers. If I have to learn something about mobile and laptop, they are always there. They know more than me. It also gives me pleasure to see my students becoming teachers and teaching in the school. Fancy, Ambika, and especially Rohini, who handles a lot of activities. I can only give my blessings to them for the future years. We have a young person from our staff room also, Jerem, who is always present for all the activities and keeps our name of Jen staff room. Otherwise, we all are very cool. Finally, I can't forget to thank our dearest father, Alhamdulillah, to his almighty, who made it impossible possible, because many of you all know that today I am standing here because of this new principle. Thanks to all again. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, Sir Shabir. We now invite our chief guest to please say a few words.
Principal of the school, Reverend Father Nicholas. Manager of Father Caesar, Secretary of the Diocesan Committee, Father Gregory Lobo, those teachers who have completed, we felicitated now, who have completed 25 years, Mr. Kandawala and Ms. Regina, my wife, Reverend Fathers, Reverend Sisters, Vice Principal, members of the staff, members of the office staff, students, and invited guests. When Father Nicholas requested me to come for as chief guest, I was quite wary about the whole thing, because when you start speaking before an audience comprising from KG to the 10th standard, and also that, it is very difficult to catch their attention unless you change tune. But my speech is not meant for the little ones. They will have a little more time to grasp the whole thing as years roll on. But as I stand before you today, I cannot but help recollecting my own school days. So, it is all, if you recollect our school days now, we find very carefree, abandoned, happy, friends, go around. And also, of course, there were dangers lurking, like a cane-wielding, mustache-twirling headmaster, whom we nicknamed Tiger. Well, I'm sorry I should say the name, because that is the name in which he was known. Till recently, I was not using that. Till the other day, his grand-nephew was working as a senior journalist in the Times. He told me, yes, that is the word, then only you will be able to recognize him. So, he used to catch us in the round when you come late by two minutes, 3 minutes, or try to sneak past the assembly. And of course, those days will never come, because now corporal punishment is banned and canes have been consigned to the museum. But I can assure you that one smack with a cane is equal to 1,000 lectures. So therefore, whatever the new votaries may say, but certainly the discipline was kept. And we are today what we are because of the school, of the teachers, of those colleagues who have inspired us. If today when we meet, you know, if whenever we meet the students, in fact you will agree that the school life, the friends we made, are the closest and they last the entire lifetime. Unlike whom we find in the college or elsewhere in the workplace, we find that those colleagues, their friendship is always very valuable, and we prize them. And any time you meet anywhere in the world, immediately you pick up the threads. So therefore, it's something very, very valuable, and I would only appeal to our students here that you should keep this friendship alive even after you pass out of the school, because it is very, very precious. The extracurricular activities also add spice to it, and the various competitions, the various, you know, extracurricular activities like sports activities, everything bonds us. And therefore, it is something very unique, school life. And therefore, we should always prize it all around. And it is on occasions like this. Actually, when I meet my own colleagues somewhere abroad and all, you always remember, yes, these were the students. What about those teachers? A lot of teachers, many of the teachers, they have, even today we speak about them. Though I'm sure they must have been there and gone long back. The English teacher who taught us English, also the various nuances of the each and every word, made us to contribute for an advanced learner's dictionary and told us how to use the sentences differently and in different contexts. The science teacher who ignited the curiosity in us, because we are all learning everything in theory only, but still. And similarly with the other biology teacher who told us what exactly cell was, and the teacher who taught us about the atom, how we could conceive an atom. No one has seen an atom, but then we know about atom. It is these people who have inspired us. And I will tell all of you that I have no hesitation in saying that our success in the future depends upon the inspiration that we have been able to imbibe from our teachers. And that is precisely the reason why the school is all schools are considered success, where the teachers are treated well and teachers give out their best. Today we form 25 years of service in my country. Our teacher, Mr. Kantawala and Mr. Regina, these are the real pillars of the school. And I congratulate, take this opportunity, congratulate both of you from the bottom of my heart for that. My teachers. Similarly, I was reading the bio today, the data which was given, that for the last 3 years, this school has been getting 100% success, 100% success. It is indeed creditable. And for that, the principals and all the teachers, and of course the students who work hard are responsible. So I commend all those principals for, and also the teachers who have made this possible in this school, which is catering primarily to the middle and also lower class categories of people. And for that, the service the school is doing is a wonderful service. As our Lord said, He has sent me, to preach good news to the poor. So for the poor and those people who are the middle class, that you are serving them. And I'm very happy that a lot of people whom I meet in various fields of life, they are so happy about the school that their children got the best of education, and they are very well placed today. And therefore, the credit must go to those, the principals and the teachers who strove so hard to make this success so sweet to all of us. And I'm sure the able hands of Father Nicholas, this will go, the tradition will go on, and also I'm sure further it will achieve, it will scale further, higher and higher heights of glory. Friends, this is an occasion like this, not the time to advise, but you can't, if you are a speaker, chief guest or a speaker, you have to give some advice to them before you go, so therefore I have to do one. The issue is about education. What is the purpose of education? Everybody will say that it's to impart knowledge. Yes, right. Imparting learning knowledge, imparting aptitudes and skill, impart morals and values, and also build character. You know, so the education which will, moral, value-based education only can build character, make you a good, useful citizen. And I'm happy to say that this Holy Name School is doing precisely that, to make citizens of tomorrow. It is man-making, what Swami Vivekananda used to call, man-making, character-building, nation-building education. And that is what you are getting here. And that you should always be thankful to the teachers and all the principal, the management, the teachers for this. And after all, education is only, you can only give it this much. It is for you to imbibe. As our W.B. Yeats had said, education is not the filling of a pail, but the lighting of a fire. It is that fire that it is ignited. Somebody was telling me earlier also that, you know, while acknowledging that, ignite this fire in this school, and that is precisely what will carry you. And then you can see each and every step you take will move you to your goal. Youth is a time when you have to dream dreams. Definitely, there's nothing wrong. In fact, this is the time when you must dream. And you must dream big also. And if you aim at the moon, at least if you miss, as some wax said, you will be among the stars at least. So therefore, you must dream, and in dreams begin the responsibility. And having decided on what you should do, what is the goal which you set for yourself, you have to work very hard for it. As Edison said, I'm just living for Edison because everybody knows Thomas Edison. The three essentials to achieve everything, anything worthwhile, are hard work, second, stick to itiveness, and third, common sense. And also a strong positive mental attitude. These are the things which will work wonders for you. These are all known. But the second one, stick to itiveness. That is, you know, stick to something what you desire. And then try and try and try until you achieve your goal. That is what you have to do. And therefore, it is very necessary that you will equip yourself with the tools required for your future life, for your future career. And one thing more, in the present era, I have to request you one thing more. Kindly, as Mr. Palkiwala often used to exhort the students, which I am passing on to you, kindly cultivate the reading habit. At time it was a very normal thing. Today to have a reading habit is a very, very difficult thing. Because you have got TV, you have got so many things vying for your attention. You have got gizmos, you have got every whatnot, internet, computer. You will find mostly children are glued to the slouching on the computer only, nothing more. There's no time to interact with others. Recently I understood that some schools are now acquiring iPads and all to help in the teaching. Very good, it is an aid to teaching, is okay. But ultimately people become addicted to it, and then you can, what suffers? Your reading habit, your interaction suffers. It is not that you know some facts and mere facts only. You should be able to appreciate those facts. You should be able to see the other view. You should be able to enjoy it. It is interactive only when you physically read. Otherwise, TV watching and anything else is not interactive at all. You know, say online, I read paper, it doesn't happen. You should cultivate a reading habit to make you a full citizen and also to expand your mind and also create general awareness in you. And many people say that, you know, people have to be lucky. Luck will come, definitely. As again, when our Jefferson said, he's a great believer in luck. I am a great believer in luck. But I find the harder I work, the more I have it. So the hard work only that brings luck. And you must all try for that, all through. And one more for the teachers who have done excellent service. This teacher, as I mentioned, even today our school, we always remember our teachers with gratitude. Wherever they are, any name taken, any time, or always we are willing to help them or their progeny or anyone, including the grand nephew of our headmaster, cane-wielding, mustache-twirling headmaster. Very helpful. But one thing is there, I only caution you. You have to continuously improve yourself. If you are to be able to be relevant in the world, to catch the imagination of the present generation, you must acquire more knowledge, more skills. In fact, all these skills which the children like to acquire with the help of gizmo, you also may have to acquire, and then their own, you will be able to catch their. Otherwise, today's children's world is totally different. They inhabit a totally different form of what when we were there. So therefore, I only want what Rabindranath Tagore said, a teacher can never truly teach unless he is still learning himself. A lamp can never light another unless it continues to burn its own flame. So this is very important that we saw just now by lighting the lamp itself. That is very demonstrated to you. So that is very necessary. The teacher has to improve. Teacher has to burn with knowledge. Teacher has to acquire more knowledge. And that I am sure it is something which I have to say, but you all know. But I just reminded you of this. And of course, parents are all at their responsibility. More than the parents, when the child goes to school, it is the teachers who are able to influence them, inspire them. And therefore, there is great responsibility on the teachers than on anybody else in the society. So I am very happy to be invited to this occasion and to speak to you. And for this beautiful, successful school, which is catering to the needs of the middle class, the poor, and also everyone else. And irrespective of caste, creed, color. And that is a great thing, and I'm very happy about it. And on this occasion, I thank Father Nicholas for giving me this opportunity. I congratulate you, Father. Keep the flag of the school flying high. And also our manager, who is also, I'm sure, he's always behind the school, always to help each and every one of us. Similarly, our Gregory Lebo, I know, Lobo, Father, Secretary, he's there in every few functions which I go. And I take only a few functions, because I get few invitations. I am fine, Father. Father is always invited, and Father has been a great champion of education in the diocese, and his name is taken by each and everyone who passed out of any school of this diocese. And for all those students who have won the prizes, my heartiest congratulations for curricular and extracurricular activities. And what about those people who have not won the prize? To them also I will tell, do not worry, because A.E. Houseman was the great poet. He failed in the very subjects, Greek and Latin, where he excelled later. And then his biographer wrote on that. What did his biographer wrote? That Nightingale did not get any prize in the poultry show. Well, I'm not saying it's a poultry show, but so this is a consolation for you. A consolation for you, Parvati. And definitely you can try and get prize the next time. Christmas season is on. So therefore, all of I take this opportunity to wish all of you Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. And also the 10th standard students who are going for the examination, I wish them all the best so that you will all come out with flying colors and distinction. Thank you.
I request our manager, Father Cesar DeMello, to speak a few words.
This is Johnny Joseph. Teachers, parents, my dear students, I think you all have had a lot of speeches. I'd like to say a sincere word of thanks to all those who have worked so hard to prepared this program. We have enjoyed the dances, songs, and on behalf of all of you, I'd also like to congratulate the winners and offer hope to those who have not won. Thank you.
Thank you, Father. The Rajasthani folk dance. Thank you.
this planet Earth.
The world in the center of the stage, lying on the floor. Her clothes are near tatters.
To your soft whispers from both sides of the stage, and different people start walking onto the stage from all over.
Please save me.
Here comes a politician.
Your politician. You spoil her. You use her to get elected. And now that the elections are over, you neglected her.
Ha! You are busy making more and more money at any cost. How you can blame me for the world's condition? This bad condition.
I built such a beautiful world. And now look at the condition. She has totally lost her color and glory. You must use adulterated cement to build the world. How could you survive for so long?
Stop, stop, stop. This world is full of sin. This is what happens when you don't pray. So pray, 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 my dear people. Pray, pray every day.
Stop this nonsense. Only a woman can understand another woman's problems. She needs help. She really needs help.
I can help her. But first, I need to check what's ailing her. Let me check.
Everyone starts shouting and blaming one another.
Wait, wait, wait. You elders, we'll never improve. First, stop screaming. We must find out how we can help her.
She's right. What's the use of blaming each other for her present condition? We must see how we can help her.
She's right. Let's not behave like children in a class without a teacher.
You said it like a true teacher. After all she has said, must be never be on time for a class.
I can help her. I will fix the world.
The engineer tries to lift the world, but fails. The businessman pulls him back.
Hey, engineer, that's not the way. She needs financial help. I'm ready to donate part of my profits for charity. How about your contribution? Your contribution and all your contribution.
I will give speeches urging all the people to donate money.
Wait, 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 wait. All your money should wait. Child, only you can help yourself. First, confess what exactly happened. Come on, rise on your feet.
The world tries to rise, but sinks further.
Ow! It's a helpless case. She must be shifted to the ICU immediately.
What? ICU?
Yes, yes, the ICU. She will not survive in this condition.
Let me at least use her as a model for my painting before she dies. I can help her after I sell my painting and earn money in dollars. Hey mother, why don't you do something? You said that one woman can help another woman.
Huh? What's the use? I'm helpless myself. I tried. Don't you think so? I tried.
I want to help. Really want to help the world. But what can a small child do all alone?
All of them sit around helplessly. Slowly, the world hides a face and starts sobbing. Just then, an old man and an old woman enter. The child runs and embraces them.
What happened, my sweet child?
Why are you looking so upset? Grandma! Grandpa! Just look at the condition of the world. She says she was so beautiful. And just look at her condition now. Look, Grandpa. Look, Grandma. Look at the beautiful world. Just look at her condition.
But then, why is everyone sitting here doing nothing? Why don't you all do something? Do something. Please, please do something.
We gave you such a beautiful world and look, look what we have done to her.
But we all tried to help her.
Yes, we all. Yes, Grandpa, each one tried to help in his or her way.
But nothing seems to help.
I think, I know.
You know what?
What the problem is.
What's the problem?
Instead of trying separately, why don't we do something together?
Right. Let's help one another. Each one will do whatever he can.
And I am sure we will make the world better.
Yes, yes. We will make the world better.
I will give the beautiful world my care.
I will provide finances for proper housing for the people of the world.
I can help.
I will rebuild the face of the world.
I will give my vote for the world. I mean, I will do whatever I can to help the world. I will get the necessary amount sanctioned in the center for the betterment of the world.
I will color the world beautiful once again.
That we must keep the world clean and pollution free.
I will pray to the Lord Almighty to give good sense to everyone and to take care of this beautiful world.
I, as a mother, what can I give? Yes, yes, I'll give all my love to the beautiful world.
I'm only a small child. What can I possibly give?
Yes, darling, that will be the greatest gift the world can receive.
Surely we all need the gift of innocence, isn't it, friends?
Yes, we do. Come on then, let's go down to work. Me a watchman, not you.
Everyone surrounds the world and starts working in his or her own way. After some time, all move away and start looking at what emerges. A shining bright and beautiful world standing there looking glorious.
Thank you. Thank you so much. You really have worked wonders. But one thing remains. Yes, only one thing remains.
And what's that?
You have to return.
We do that
by walking together.
Like we did a while ago.
Let's come together
and make a ladder to the sky.
What? Ladder?
Yes, yes, ladder to the sky.
Yes, indeed. Walking together can achieve miracles.
From one end to another, tenderly, they pass the world till she reaches the end of the stage.
And once again, the world was strong, healthy, and happy. Just high in the sky.
need two more dancers to come on the stage. The name that is given, the Holy Name High School, has to be changed to Holy Name Dance Academy. My sincere thanks to all the teachers and two choreographers and of their assistants, Sumit and Sapan. I call upon the stage, please. Who worked tirelessly for last 8 to 12 days, training our students to put up such a wonderful performance. This is Sumit and Mr. Sapan. Congratulations and thank you. So our teachers, those were day to day out, helping the students to come for the practices, taking the practices, helping the choreographers. The stage decoration, that is, you can see the theme, the title that has been put up here. Each and every step you take moves you to your goal. It is truly right. Because our students, as you have seen, coming on the stage and receiving prizes, so many students coming on the stage and performing the various dances, skits, etc. There is no other alternative or substitute for the hard work. Each step that you take, you reach your goal. You can never give up, never quit, but always try. And that is the what we help our children to learn. But the parents, I thank you all for having placed your trust in us, entrusting your children to take to our care, to shape them, to mold them, to educate them. But of course, it is not only the responsibility of the teachers and the management, but it is your responsibility too. Because as you all know very well, that right to education has made the education stress-free. Children are not stressed out at all. Even if they don't go to school, they will pass. That is what the government has made a policy, and we are to abide with it. What it will prove to in future, we do not know. Let us know, the 10 standard students this year are the victims of this policy. They have been pushed up from the 7th to 8th, naturally from 8th to 9th and 9th to 10th they have come in. They will prove to us whether this policy is applicable and right for our students' development. But of course, the parents' vital role is also important, because it is you who need to motivate our students, understand them, show them the care, love, and sincerely helping them to know that you love them. If that is there, definitely they will be motivated to study too. And dear parents, thanks for all the support that you have been giving to us to educate your children. Along with us, you also have been trying your best to educate. My sincere thanks to our manager, with the fathers of the church as well as the bishop's house, who gives lots of encouragement to me ever since that I've taken this assignment since last 6 months. Father Xavier, Father Caesar, Father Bento, Father Nigel, Father Neil, Father Savio, Father Jervis, Monsignor, Father Anthony, they're all the backbones to me. In fact, they're the one who inquires everything about the school every day as to how and what's going on. Yes, the word of appreciation, the word of encouragement definitely strengthens us, me as well as my teachers, to do the best to our students and also help them to grow. Once again, my sincere thanks to all the teachers, the pupils, as well as the office staff for the work they have put in, the efforts they have put into for the success of this program today. Sound, Mr. Ahuja, who has provided sounds to us. Mr. Mahesh Patel, who has provided the lights for this function. And also Mr. Sebastian, the decorator, who has made the stage as well as given us the sitting arrangement. My sincere thanks to all of them for their contribution towards the success of this program. Once again, my sincere thanks to you, my dear parents, for being with us here this evening. Without you, our students would not get the encouragement to dance on the stage and perform. All the prize winners, my congratulations to you, my dear students. Hope you'll keep up and every year you'll receive these prizes and also come up in your life, because as it is written there, each and every step that you take, that will help you to reach to your success, to your goal. Keep up the spirit that you have, do well in this your examinations, but also at the same time, all the students, those who are taking part in the programs, etc., they also put in studies, no doubt about it. It should be all-round formation, and therefore to take is not only the certificates for the academic excellence, but also the co-curricular activities, etc., that we take. If you try to excel in all this, definitely you will be someone to face the future, which is very uncertain to us. Yes, my dear students, try hard, get motivated, work hard so that you will definitely face the future. Once again, my sincere thanks to all of you all, to the students and the other students, those who also helped us during this day, whole day, to put up the chairs and also the other arrangement that was made. It is because of their help, because of the contribution that we could do well here. Once again, as I said, it is not only the teachers, but even the parents play a vital role in educating children. I know the task is difficult, but it is not impossible. With Almighty God's help, everything is possible. And therefore, pray to Almighty God for the success of our students, our children. As I said, our students, our children's future is uncertain. You can make it certain by your presence, by your motivation, by your help and guidance. God bless you all.
Oh. children